If you find yourself sending messages to ChatGPT and asking it to reword what it produces for you, then you are going to love this video. I'm going to be breaking down for you how you can use no-code automation to communicate with ChatGPT on this repetitive process so that with just a few clicks of a button, you can tell ChatGPT to rephrase whatever you have in text into whatever tone of voice you desire. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the founder here at Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Make is one of our favorite no-code tools and it is going to be at the forefront of what we are using here today. Before we get into it, I suggest you open up your own account in make.com so that you can follow along with me right here side by side. If you don't already have Make, be sure to sign up with our affiliate link wherever you found this video. Doing so will allow you to start your own free trial on a pro account while you get set up inside of Make and feel it out and decide if it's a good fit for you. Find that link wherever you found this video. But now let's go ahead and get into the heart of things. Here I am in my Airtable interface. I have my input text right here. Make is an incredible automation tool. It helps me create automation for so many tasks, saves me countless hours every week. I choose a text tone. I want this aggressive. I choose a specific voice, maybe a scummy lawyer. And then with the click of a button, I send this information to make.com and it produces for me an output taking this input text and taking these variables into consideration, and then it updates that text. So here's what I got a moment ago. If you're not already using make.com, then let me tell you, you're wasting precious time on mundane tasks like a clueless individual. This bloody brilliant tool magically automates all that nonsense for you. I swear on my expensive tie. What? I swear on my expensive tie. It'll save you hours each week. You'll be wondering how you could have been so blind before. Jump on this fast track to efficiency before you're left in the dust, you hear? That is aggressive. And this definitely got scummy lawyer written all over it. But check it out. I can totally rephrase this if I want to. Heck, I can even take this text and I can make this my new input text. And I can send it to Make all over again, but totally change the tone. Let's make it flirty from Sophia Loren. Simply make the changes to my variables. I click Get New Output Text. We're gonna have to give Make just a moment because of course it's sending this information to ChatGPT and it's being written in the background. Ah, here we go. Darling, if you're yet to discover the magic of make.com, let me assure you, you're missing out on a delightful affair. Totally changed the tone of this little prose here. I'm excited to show you exactly how we built this, but first we have to break it down in Airtable before we get to the automation magic. So, heading on over into Airtable, this is what our data looks like. Now, for the primary field, I've just used an auto number. I really don't care what these are called. If you do, and you want to use some text here to identify them, go right ahead and do so. Now I've got my input text field. Now for me, this is just a long text field so I can type as much as I'd like inside of this field. Next, I have my two dropdowns, one for text tone and one for the tone of voice. So here, this is my tone. There we go. I've got a few different options and of course we can always add new ones. And then I've got some different voices, scummy lawyer and some different celebrities, and we're all set. Now one hack that I really like to implement, if possible, is to build a formula for my prompt to ChatGPT. This makes it a lot easier when you build your actual automation. All I have to do is map this one field right to ChatGPT when I'm inside of Make. If you don't understand what I'm talking about, we're gonna get to that part a little bit later in the video. But I wanna build a formula that takes these different input variables. It takes the original text, it takes the different tone and the voice, and then it produces an output. Here's what that looks like. Effectively, it's just a long concatenate formula. This concatenate formula is saying, hey, listen, this is the original message right here. I have some input text. Notice I keep that in quotes so that it knows that it's a field that I'm going to pass over to it. And I want your help rewording that text. It's important that we keep the message in the context and we don't change the meaning. I only want you to update the text tone and or the voice of the message. Notice I said and or. This is important as well because inside of my formula, I've actually added these if conditions. If I have selected a text tone, or if I have selected a voice element, well, in those conditions, I'm going to pass along some extra information to ChatGPT. But I don't always have them. Maybe I don't have a specific tone of voice, but I do have a text tone that I want to implement here, or vice versa. So in either case, I'm using this little if selection or this if function inside of my formula. And it basically says, if a text tone exists, well, then I want to further concatenate this little saying. In your response, please consider a specific tone for this message. I would like your answer to be phrased with a blank tone of voice. Or, over here, if there exists a voice, well, in addition, please also consider a specific speaker voice in your reply. Please create a reply in the voice of blank. And that's it. At the end of this whole thing, I'm adding this little tidbit. Please take creative liberty in your reply. Feel free to shorten or lengthen your response if it better suits the output. And that's it. So take a look at what this produces for us. Rather than sending over and mapping all these different fields to ChatGPT, well, now I have one nice output that I can just map right over to ChatGPT, and it includes everything that I need. In this case, it says, hi, ChatGPT, I've got some input text. Then it says, here is the input text. And then inside of these quotations, you see that input text. Then I have a new line that says, in your response, please consider a specific tone. And in this case, I brought in the flirty tone. And then lastly, down here, please create a reply in the voice of Woody Allen. There we go. We have all the different elements here. I see as I read this back that maybe I missed some punctuation here and there, but it doesn't change the final output that we get from ChatGPT. So let's now head into that automation. To start things off, we are watching responses. This is a webhook that we can set up through an Airtable automation. We've done this in numerous different videos before, and this is the preferred way of creating a trigger with ChatGPT and make.com. The reason for this is make will charge us based on operations. An operation is any time it tries to perform an automation. Well, in many cases, some of the triggers for Airtable in particular will watch records in Airtable. And if they go out and they look every few minutes, but they don't find anything, they're still gonna charge us an operation. We don't wanna be charged for those operations. So when we build this kind of a trigger using this webhook, notice that it has this lightning bolt symbol down here. This means that this will only trigger when it receives that information, and it will trigger instantly. So there's a big advantage to using this because we will not be charged for operations going looking for stuff in Airtable. This will only begin when it actually receives information. Now, what's it going to receive? Well, it receives the record ID. So in the next step, what we do is we take the record ID that we received in this step, and we go and we look it up in Airtable so that we can come back with all of the other information about this particular record. Now, in the third step, we're going to talk to ChatGPT. And we've simply mapped this up so that we're taking our formula output and putting it in here in one fell swoop. Notice that I didn't have to write out a long prose here inside of my automation. It's way easier for me, I think, to just take this formulaic output from Airtable, plug it into one place, and the rest is going to be done for us. Nice and easy. Now, lastly, we're going to take whatever output we receive from ChatGPT, go back into Airtable, and update that record. So we're plugging in the record ID again, and we are updating the output text in Airtable. So now that we have this mapped out inside of Make, let's flip back into our interface again and play around with some new things. So here I have three different options that I can select. These are pre-existing records. So here is one where I said, I love no-code tools because they allow me to automate all kinds of stuff. And I asked to receive a response that was flirty in Woody Allen's voice, and I got this reply. The allure of no-code tools, oh, it's undeniable, simply irresistible. Gives me the goosebumps truly. It's like they dance to my every command, automating all sorts of tasks. Absolutely splendid, isn't it? Kind of weird? So is Woody Allen. So let's go ahead and change things up and see if maybe we can get a better reply, something else rather, that has a different tone of voice and perhaps a different celebrity voice to it as well. Let's pick William Shatner here, and we'll do just a very passive William Shatner reply. Click on that button to get my output text. Again, we gotta wait just a little bit. We can actually flip back into Make to see how it's processing this data. Here it goes. We see that it actually just finished. So I can flip back to my interface to see the update. Ah, the beauty and simplicity of these no-code solutions has always been my fascination. You see, they facilitate a level of automation that simply seems ineffably transformative for our daily mundane tasks. Rather intriguing, don't you think? It's a lot of words to not say a lot of stuff. That's totally William Shatner. I love how they even included the ellipse here. That's perfect. This is awesome stuff. If you find yourself rewording things a lot, putting it in a different tone of voice, you are going to love this automation. Now, before I sign off, I do want to check one more thing. What happens if I have a blank variable here? Can I still get a new output? If I, let's say, wanted to make this rephrased in a spiteful tone of voice, but I didn't have a celebrity voice I wanted to hear this reply in. Well, can I click this in this case? Here we go. You see that it's already sent the information to Make. We're waiting on ChatGPT here. Sometimes it does take a bit. We got that reply. Let's head back to Airtable and see what we got. The charm of these no-code tools is absolutely irresistible, isn't it? Some kind of magical wand, turning us from mere mortals into automation wizards. So yes, they have me entranced too, providing the ability to automate any darn thing, quite effortlessly, I must add. I don't know if I agree that this is spiteful, but it did say darn thing, so it got pretty violent there, I guess. I'll leave it up to you to determine what your different adjectives and different tones of voice are that you might want to rephrase things in. But ultimately, this can be a really helpful tool, especially if you're doing a lot of copywriting and trying to rephrase things in different ways. I hope you got a ton of value from this. Drop any questions you have below wherever you found this video. And in the meantime, keep on building.